Well, a major victory for Republicans and a crushing defeat for Democrats. Georgia Republican Karen Handel winning the most expensive House race in history by a bigger margin than expected. And the GOP chalking up another victory in South Carolina, raising questions about House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi's future. Kyle Condick is a political analyst at the University of Virginia Center for Politics. So what is her future, Nancy Pelosi?
Well, I think her future's probably fine for now, but, you know, the record for Democrats in the House since they lost 63 seats in 2010 has really been quite poor. Since that time, they've only netted one additional seat and have been stuck fairly deeply in the minority. And, you know, when the Democratic House caucus met at the start of the year, they actually had a vote to see who the leader would be, and Representative Tim Ryan of Ohio actually didn't win the leadership, obviously, but got about a third of the vote. And I think there is some grumbling about Pelosi, if only because the electoral record is poor and also because Republicans continue to be able to attack her with a lot of success, I think, in Republican-leaning districts like Georgia 6 decided last night.
I mean, the record under Nancy Pelosi is this: since 2010, 63 seats have been lost for Democrats, and since then, that's a net one seat gain. Democrats have got to look at this and say, what is our future, and what do they need to change, particularly before 2018?
Well, part of it is that whenever there's a president of one party, the other party tends to gain in the House and Senate and governor's races. And so the Democrats are kind of working at a handicap in the Obama years. But now we've got a Republican president, Donald Trump. His numbers aren't particularly very good. Democrats, should have a decent chance to gain a lot of seats next year. If they don't, they're going to have to do a lot of soul searching. And some Democrats may already be worried that maybe they're not prepared or they're not positioned to perform as well as maybe they should next year.
Well, let's take a look at some of those recent numbers. According to the latest Gallup poll, the president's approval rating stands at 37%, disapproval 57%. Kyle, obviously this isn't there's no indication here that Republicans can just sit tight and think everything's going to be okay. Do they need to make some changes as well?
Well, I certainly think that if the president's approval rating is in the high 30s or low 40s next year, the Democrats are going to pick up some seats in the House, probably in governorships too, maybe not in the Senate because just the Senate map is really bad for Democrats next year. But, historically speaking, Trump's numbers look a lot like George W. Bush in 2006, where Republicans lost the House and the Senate, and in other midterm elections where the president's party has fared poorly. So I think Republicans have a lot to be happy about with the results from last night, but I don't think that they should just think that, we're going to be totally fine in the midterms next year, because history suggests an unpopular president will drag his party down.
All right, Kyle Condick, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.